Sergei Golubitsky in Conegliano, Italy, the town where I train, and I'd like to present the footage of tournament in 91 in Vienna and 2001 in Venice, my first World Cup victory and the last victory. And between this tournament lies a period of 10 years, and you easily, I believe, can see the difference of my fencing style and tactics and the way I equip technically. In the final of World Cup in Vienna, I fenced I.Weißenborn, German fencer, which a couple months earlier won World Championships in Budapest. And it turned to be a pretty easy victory for me. In my last World Cup tournament in Venice, I fenced Simone Vanni, I fenced C.Gohy from Belgium, I fenced Bence Juhas, the Hungarian fencer. For top two, I fenced Mocek, the Polish fencer, and for the first, Christian Schlechtweg, the fencer from Germany. The thing is, like, my last victory in 2001 in Venice, I was injured, and it's like I had pain during all bouts, and I hardly could walk, and still I was really happy. And but it was a different type of happiness, kind of sad one. And but still, it was nice to feel like you finished career and by winning, and you sort of walk away as a winner. Next one, and actually, that was also the moment when the pain was so huge that I was thinking to sort of maybe I should quit fencing this tournament. And then I decided no, I go on because it's I came to Venice to fence and not to give up. So I decided like fence with my character and will and just go on, and I succeeded to win. See on the screen there is a flag of the Soviet Union, the country which doesn't exist right now. And as always, I started about investigating the Ingo a little bit, trying to see what he's doing actually.
Would you say that he's more an aggressive type fencer, or was he the type that's kind of subtle move?
He's pretty aggressive fencer, and often sort of his lucky attacks and his advanced lunge is very, very powerful, very fast. So, and therefore I decided from the beginning to take initiative and also trying to keep safe distance for myself, so therefore he couldn't really develop his attacks. As you can see, I'm trying to make different things within simultaneous finishing the forward and then pairing and trying to give a pause. That's important. You have to mix up tempo all the time if you want to be a successful fencer.
One thing I noticed is that in this bout, which is earlier in your career, it seems like you're moving a lot more and much more kind of quick as opposed to later in your career where it's more explosive.
Yeah, actually, good question, because it's true, I'm moving all the time, constantly. And that's the way it's supposed to be, actually. But later on, and you can see it on the video of Venice. I move sort of less, but still I'm much more effective. So therefore, as I said earlier, the first video I said that you have to be fast enough, so but you have to do things right in time, and that's what counts in the end. I won first bout 5-1. And, as I said, look, you can look at my face. I'm just really relaxed and I'm going pretty well. And as you can see also, I'm making much more mini flicks than, let's say, in the end of my career.
Now, how do you determine if you should fence offensively or defensively against somebody? What signs do you look for that trigger you to say, okay, I need to be defensive, or I should really start attacking this guy?
Yeah, it's simply, yeah. You have to decide for yourself what you want to do and then choose the right moment. Therefore, if I'm analyzing, let's say, and I see that I have pretty good chances in it to score an attack, I have to make some attack. Therefore, but which one, I have to figure out myself as well. And as you can see here, I'm leading the whole thing. So Ingo already not in the mood to resist, let's say. So I do what I want to do, and I score attacks with lean. I score attacks with, as you can see, like flashes. I make, I take in risk, but I mean, I know that I feel that I'm gonna win, sort of. So it's. It depends. Depends which day you have. If you have your days, everything seems nice and easy. And again, another lean.
Yeah, that was a nice one.
Thank you, Dan.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah, now I just need just one touch, let's say, and I'm gonna win. And here it comes. So as you can see, I'm hurt pretty badly now. But luckily I was leading. I had an advantage, pretty big one.
Was it 14-5 already, actually, when you picked up the action here?
Yeah. I didn't see this footage for a year or even more than that, and it's really incredible what I'm doing out there. It's like, especially considering that I can't move. So this is next bout with Sergei Golubitsky, and I fenced him, I don't know, 2-3 times I think, and never lost to the guy, so I was pretty convinced that I'm gonna pull it off despite my injury. And actually I was leading the whole bout, but just in the middle, let's say, my attention sank down, so the guy could catch up on me, and then led it in 11-9. So just enjoy watching this bout, and I think time to time I'm gonna give some comments. eight seconds left to the end of the period, and Goy made Perry repost, and the moment he touched me, the time was up, so there were no light. And he said, "You're lucky, man." So the time is about to run over, and Cedric tries to catch up, and it's almost impossible. Right now I'm standing there on the final strip, and I already announced to organizers of the tournament that I'm going to quit fencing, so in Italian language they're announcing that to the public. So I'm saying my last goodbye.
Thank you. have to invent a motto for this bout. I'd say I call this bout, you should never give up. And you'll see that Mocek gonna take initiative, gonna lead from the beginning and almost to the very end of the bout. And I had to catch up. And that was pretty hard job to do, but I managed to do that. So for young fencers especially, I recommend to watch this bout closely. Completely lost the beginning, and as you can see, Mocek moves pretty good out there, and I couldn't find keys against his actions, you know. And I still believe that I can win this bout. And as you see, I'm not worrying a lot or something. It's not like I'm changing my fencing immediately. I'm doing something like extraordinary. But I'm taking my time, and actually the pain in the foot was a little bit less, so I could move a little bit better, and therefore later on I could find the right rhythm against his attacks, against his actions, and could succeed doing that.
Go, Sergei. Yeah.
here it is, and it's second in a row, so it seems I at that moment I found some keys against his attacks, which were pretty explosive and pretty fast ones. So, and actually, as you can see, it's 6-5. I'm getting pretty comfortable, but then Mocek switches on second gear and he'll go.
Come on, Sergei. Go, Sergei!
Un minuto, un minuto.
lost against him, so I was pretty relaxed, and even pain in my foot didn't matter anymore. I knew that I'm gonna lose. I was really sure about it. One of my favorite touches is coming, the lean. I'm gonna make a fake counterattack pair of repos, and I think this is like the classical action, which is in fact very difficult to make. Actually, it was funny because at this point, Christian took his mask off and he was smiling because it was like really beautiful touch, and he couldn't do anything. And I sort of said like, "Yeah, I'm sorry."
Thank you.
clean, but he will say the referee won't give it for me. And it's really, really sad sometimes.
Non si può. No,
So, fencing is a really great sport, I believe, and it's one of the best in the world. And the strange thing is that because of injury, I didn't train for a while before this tournament, and I still could win it because of work I've done within all these years. I invested like all my time and will for one thing, to be the best at trying to be the best out there, and it all paid off. So it was nice to finish my own career with such a nice victory in such a beautiful city as Venice. And I wish to all of you my kind of success.
This is the last lesson before Paris. All right.
Without feeling, you just gradually find the feeling. So many.